Take this as your last warning, Maxwell. The next time we get serious.
The minister's making a special trip out at my request.
Oh, and what's the occasion?
A discussion of your attempts to undermine my running of the prison.
Well, it saves me the effort of writing a report, doesn't it?
And colouring his attitude with half-truths and omissions. Make sure you're there. I want this matter cleared up once and for all.
No! Bitch! So help me, I'll kill the next person who lays a finger on me! Already on one murder charge, I'm quite willing to wear another if I'm forced to. Anyone can talk big with one of them in their hands. We'll be seeing.
Jeez, what happened to you?
Maxwell went me with a knife.
The little bitch!
I thought there was a true song.
Not anymore, there's not.
Screws, no?
I don't know. I told him I did it in here and was on my way to see Sister Hall. I don't know if they believe me.
What are you going to do about it?
Wait till Reckon will go and bust the bitch.
Yeah!
So fast. I don't want you ending up like salamis.
We can handle her with our hands tied.
Oh, that's for sure.
She's got Williams hanging around her like a blowy and they both got blamed.
Oh, I told you it was a waste of time being friendly to that lot.
Well, we should do something before she hurts somebody else.
Yeah, let's go get the bitch now.
I'll be in it. Shut up, the lot of you, and listen to me.
I'm not going to let her get away with it, but we've got to pick our moment. And when we do, we'll go in full throttle.
Yeah, well, when's that going to be?
When she's not hanging around with Blaze. Until then, her and Williams are both in Coventry, and you lot stay in here, OK?
Did you bring the photo album?
They're checking it in reception.
And the money?
It's behind a photo. They won't find it. What's it for?
Protection. It's the only way to stay alive in this place.
You mean someone's tried to kill you?
I just need protection, that's all.
Oh, sounds terrible. I can't get over how different you seem.
I'm in prison, remember?
Bob, gave me your messages.
Why haven't you been to visit?
Well, I've been really busy at work and I
haven't... Alan, I'm your wife.
Well, it's not easy getting used to the idea of having a wife in prison.
It's not easy being in here 24 hours a day, 7 days a week without word from your husband either.
Kath, please. You're changing. This place is affecting you just like Bob said it would.
What did you expect? I have to survive somehow.
Yeah, well, stop your yakking and give us a day.
Is this all?
Well, it's not my fault if the old geezer's going broke.
Can't anything go bloody well right?
Well, don't get aggro.
You cut out yelling at her. It's your bloody fault. If you hadn't run down Dan the man and tried to get Rita out, none of this would have bloody happened.
Shut your face! I'm not having me sister spend the rest of her life in there. Making him into a bloody wimp.
Well, you won't be much help once you nick off.
I told you I'd come back when the cops stopped looking for me.
I want to come with you.
I told you, no way! I'll see you when I get back.
You gonna write to me?
Writing's for sucks.
If you don't, I'll dob you into the coppers.
Yeah, sure you will, you old bag.
I'll leave her alone. We've both been helping you, remember?
Well, then don't go preaching to me, then. I know how you can help me.
Oh, yeah. How?
Give us something to remember us by. Be real lonely when I'm gone.
I thought you were in a hurry.
Not that much. Let's go.
God.
Well, they're obviously keeping you busy.
Yeah, well, you know the company's policy. Keep the clients happy at all costs.
I think you better go. Time must be nearly up.
Kath. Look, there's something else that I have to tell you.
You're not coming back, are you?
I've been offered a job in Perth.
Perth? You'd hate it over there.
Well, I can't stand being alone in the house anymore.
Yeah, but Perth?
Look, I just got to have some time to work things out.
Work what out?
Look, I've already accepted the job. The press has been hounding me ever since you were charged, and the trial hasn't even started yet.
It's all right, Alan, I understand.
Look, I'll be in touch. All right.
Yes, of course you will.
Yeah. Well, look, I better go.
Alan, there's just one more thing I want you to do for me.
What?
I need more money. Bring me one more lot and then...
What if I get caught?
Please. Promise me you'll do it.
All right.
The woman never stops. She takes every opportunity to provoke me. She keeps dangling this mysterious informer of hers in front of me like a red rag.
Well, she wants your job.
Yes. And the more trouble she causes, the more inefficient she makes me look. But I will not tolerate insubordination.
And that's why you called the minister.
This time I'm getting in first. Hello? Could someone bring him straight through, please? Thank you. He's here now. Could you get Joan and ask her to see me?
Right. Good luck.
Thank you.
Then I noticed it was bleeding. I guess I must have cut it on something.
But you can't remember what, hmm? I don't see any blood or indeed any sharp edges.
It's funny, that. Still, I can't think of how else I could have done it.
Dangerous places, prisons.
Yeah, I vote we shut them down, they'll let us all go home.
Hey, yeah, good one.
All those in favour?
Hey. Unanimous.
Shut up, Patterson, unless you want a charge. You all think you're very smart, don't you? Trying to set up the Maxwell woman and thinking we wouldn't find out.
How do you mean, Miss Ferguson?
I mean you and Jenkins spraying the woman with the fire extinguisher.
Don't know what you're talking about.
Of course not. You never do.
It's a pretty heavy accusation. You got any proof?
This is just a warning, Connors. I want this place running smoothly. Any more stunts like the one with the fire extinguisher, and you will find yourself in Blackmore faster than I can sign the transfer papers.
I heard it was choppers.
Oh, there's always room for scum like you. Just thank your lucky stars you're not there already. Now get your work done.
Miss Ferguson, can I see you, please? The minister's here. The governor wants to see you in her office.
Right, on the way.
Excuse me, Mrs. M.
Yes, what is it, Jenkins?
Well, is it true that Miss Ferguson can have us sent to Blackmore now she's deputy governor?
Well, she can make a recommendation to the governor. Why do you ask?
Oh, nothing. I just wondered, that's all.
Well, the best way to avoid being transferred is to stay out of trouble, right?
Yeah, I suppose so.
How do you reckon the freak knew about Maxwell?
The bitch probably lagged.
Nah, there's no charges been laid, though.
Unless the freak's just testing it, she guessed it herself already.
No, I reckon it's got to be Maxwell.
There's no way I'm going to Blackmore because of her.
Oh, come on, Rita, we've got to do something about the bitch.
Ah, cool down, will you? If we waste Maxwell now, we give Ferguson all the ammo she needs to split us up. Split the warriors up? There's no way I'm going to let that happen.
How'd you go? Get the moolah? Who's that?
It's Alan, just before he joined the army. That's my daughter. God, she was a beautiful child. We were so proud of her.
Did he bring in the dough? Yes, he did bring in the dough. I just asked a bloody question. That's why I came in, isn't it?
Not quite. He said he's leaving me, going to Perth.
Mongrel. You can never trust him.
A photo album. Not much to show for a whole life, is it?
You'll get over it. Where'd you hide the dough?
In here. Appropriate, really. Felt like he was paying me off, clearing his conscience for leaving me. And for Linda.
Stop yakking about your dead brat and give us the money. Don't you ever talk about my child like that again, or I'll kill you. There's your money.
It's behind the photos.
You better keep knit. Just in case there's some screws around. Beauty. We'll be able to pay for the hardware and buy a bit of extra muscle with all this.
I will not be told how to run the prison by my deputy governor. I expect you to abide by my decisions and not go running to the department every time we disagree.
And you like to reply to that, Miss Ferguson?
Well, sir, I can see that Mrs. Reynolds is upset about this, and I may have been a bit strong in presenting my opinion.
You made it quite plain you don't support me and don't trust my judgment.
Well, perhaps in the heat of the moment I said something.
Sir, it's an impossible situation.
Mrs. Reynolds.
Sir, if I may say one thing.
Mm-hmm.
If I have offended the governor, then I'm sorry. I know that sometimes I'm guilty of, well, taking my work too seriously, but I have always acted to the very best of my abilities. And I can assure Mrs. Reynolds that I will be working to improve our relationship in the future.
Well, sir. That all right, Mrs. Reynolds? Oh, thanks, Miss Ferguson. That'll be all for now.
Thank you, sir.
I think she's a very capable officer who may say a little more than she should at times, but there we are.
I repeat, she is using her so-called source to undermine my authority.
No. It's the women are doing that. She's simply telling you about it. Now, if you don't like it, I suggest you tighten up security. Then she'll have nothing to report.
Miss Ferguson lacks judgment. She wanted me to interrogate Maxwell until the woman lagged. She wouldn't last a night after that. The last thing any of us need in here is another murder.
Then stop the trouble before it starts, as Miss Ferguson suggests.
When can I expect the extra staff I requested?
I'll have to make do with what you've got at the moment. Money's tight.
Minister, it makes an impossible situation.
Mrs. Reynolds.
Constant interference.
I believe that Miss Ferguson has done an exemplary job as deputy governor, and that is the end of it. Good day.
I'll be out for a few hours, so I'll see you after lunch.
All right, darling.
And stop worrying, will you?
I'll try. Hello, Wentworth Detention Centre. I'd like to arrange a visit to see a Miss Julie Egbert, please.
And he told her to keep up the good work.
I don't believe it.
Not only that, he virtually threatened to replace me if I didn't let the issue drop. With Joan, of course.
Oh, of course. Oh, she's certainly got him wrapped around her little finger, hasn't she?
I feel so damned helpless. I'm half tempted to resign and let him find out for himself.
Oh, she botched it up the last time she was in your seat. Now, remember what you said to me about giving her enough rope to hang herself? Well, she'll do it, eventually.
I don't know if I can wait that long.
Hold on a second, stop here. Unit 75 to BKC.
BKC to Unit 75, over.
Unit 75, request information on vehicle used in connection with Mookbar robbery this morning, over.
Okay, Unit 75, retrieving details now. Rego number CBA321, Morris, 1965. Over.
Confirmed sighting above vehicle at 95 Morak Street. Preparing to move in, over.
Hold on that, 75. Suspects believed to be connected with Brian Connors, wanted for Wentworth escape attempt. May be armed. Maintain observation until backup arrives. Over.
Understood, BKC. Out. Better backup out of sight. Looks like we're in for some action.
Should have taken me Harley instead of the motor mower.
Too risky. Cops would recognise it.
Yeah. Well, I'll see you in a couple of weeks, eh?
Give us a kiss before we go.
Oh, good. You've done all that inside.
Bloody pigs! He's seen us. Let's go.
Come on, you two.
suspect headed in the direction of Fuller Park on trail bike. Rego, BW 258.
Hooray! Hooray! Come on, Bongo Boy! Told you we'd make it.
I'll put a sock in it, both of you.
Suspect cancel request for assistance.
Nancy?
Oh.
I'm sorry, I didn't mean to startle you.
Oh, that's all right, Mervyn. I was just practicing.
Well, actually, I want to talk to you about the video gear.
It's not been damaged, has it?
No, but I was talking to Jill in the kitchen and she said you had some idea about a video club of some sort.
Oh, that's all it is. Just an idea. I think Lexie's been a bit optimistic, thinking Jesse will pay for one.
Well, that's just it. I was talking to Uncle Percy on the phone and he's offered to let you use his equipment for a while.
Oh, but I thought you said he was an enthusiast. Doesn't he want to use it himself?
Well, yes. Well, he's been wanting to buy a new camera for ages. You know, one of those with all those doodads on it. And he said leaving the one here is just the excuse he needs to buy it.
With some encouragement from you.
Well, I just told him you liked his video, that's all.
Oh, but that's wonderful, Mervyn.
Of course, you have to take care of it, and I'll be leaving you in charge.
Well, I'll guard it with my life. When can we start using it?
As soon as I've double-checked with Mrs. Reynolds.
Oh, I'll go and tell the girls. They'll be so excited. Oh, you're a very sweet man, Mervyn.
I banged my bloody hand.
Just want me to work the press?
No, I'd do it whatever I was working on. That Maxwell bitch has got a lot to answer for.
Yeah, well, swap your sore hand for morning sickness any day.
Jesse, you're still sick.
Oh, bitch. Hey, you'll know what it's like when you start having kids with Stevie, babe.
Hey, how many are you gonna have?
Oh, we haven't even talked about it. I don't know, 2 or 3, 20. Hey, everyone, guess what?
The Martians are coming.
The freaks joined the girl guide.
Hey, we've all got royal pardons.
I'm gonna get the burps just me up.
We're gonna have a bona fide video club.
Huh? What kind of club's that, Nancy?
Well, the chap who made Mervyn and Joyce's video, Purse, he's agreed to leave his equipment here indefinitely, and we can use it.
Yeah. Straight on. You mean we can really make our own movies?
Yeah, that's right. Hey, iBag's making one about me and the gym instructor.
Yeah, King Kong meets Frankenstein.
Oh, take it easy, will
you? What are you doing here during work hours?
Oh, I've just come to tell the women something.
Can wait till lunchtime. Get out. Egbert, I've got a visitor.
Who is it?
A Mrs. Ryan.
Steve's mum.
Well, come along. Let's not keep the lady waiting. There you are, Egbert. Have a nice visit.
Thank you, officer. I'm sure we will. Sit down, dear. You seem a little nervous. Not because of me, I hope.
Well, I wasn't sure you'd approve of me and Steve.
Well, I won't pretend I wouldn't like the circumstances to be different, but Stephen's clearly very fond of you, and that's enough for me. You've had a little problem with your parole.
Yeah.
What exactly went wrong, dear?
Well, I think it was because some of the girls smuggled in some drink and things and I got involved. I didn't mean to.
Yes, I suppose in here it's very easy to get into serious trouble.
Yeah. Even if it's not your fault, they put you on a charge and they add extra time to your sentence.
Really? Well, never mind, dear. I'm sure the time will pass really quickly.
Oh, that's just the end of work bell.
Tell me, how do the officers feel about you and Stephen?
Well, I think most of them are happy for us.
I just had this feeling, reading Stephen's thesis, there was one particular officer, most unpleasant person. She didn't seem to approve very much of anything.
Yeah, that'd be Miss Ferguson. She's the one that brought me in. She's deputy governor.
Miss Ferguson, I see. Well, you must try very hard not to antagonize her. She could make things really difficult for you and Stephen. And we certainly don't want that, do we?
No. Oh, my love, my darling. You don't know how it hurts for you to leave me like this.
But I must, my beloved.
Does this mean it's over?
No. I promise. I shall return someday.
When I get my parole, that is.
You promise you'll be serious.
Oh, what? Can we sit back now?
No, let's get some more done first. Come on, Alice, it's your turn.
Oh, get off it, Ned. I couldn't act to save me life.
I thought you said you wanted to.
Oh, it's different now. The camera's going. Sort of freeze up.
Oh, no, no, I don't want you to act. Just be natural.
Like they were.
Oh, not exactly.
Oh, what do you mean? I was natural there.
A little overdone, I think, perhaps. It doesn't matter. We can do it again. That's the beauty of the camera.
I could have moved to lend us that thing, wasn't it?
It's got to be a scam we can use it for somewhere.
No, look, we've got this so we can learn something and be serious about it. You know, get out some books on filming and learn to do it properly.
Oh, come on, Nance. It's just a bit of a lark.
Well, if that's the way you feel, we might just as well stop it now. Come on, Alice. I want you to do one of your trick pool shots.
I don't know any.
Oh, yes, you do. You know the one where you keep missing the pocket?
Now, you might be surprised. I want to take a shot of you hitting the white ball, and then I want to fake a close-up shot of a coloured ball falling into the pocket.
You know what she's talking about?
Yeah, she's using trick photography to make Lurch look like a pool shark. We let everyone see the tape and set up a game. Everyone bets on Lurch and we clean up.
I told you, no scams. Oh, I don't know why bother.
Hey, had to go. What happened?
It's all right. We got her blessing.
Oh,
you know, from what Steve said, I thought she'd be really stuck up and snooty and everything, but she's not. Nancy, don't.
Oh, no, don't stop talking, Julie. Go on, keep going. There's something to show your grandchildren.
Yeah, not to mention Steve.
It's your big break into showbiz.
Oh, I hope you're being careful with that, lady.
Oh, yes, yes, we are, Mrs. Barry. Oh, I'm sorry, Mrs. Pringle.
Perhaps we'll see you all at the next Academy Awards.
Woo-hoo!
Connors. Mrs. Reynolds wants to see you.
Well, I told you it was an accident in the laundry.
Yeah, we can all vouch for that.
Yeah.
Come on, let's not keep her waiting.
Oh, what are you doing?
Nancy!
It's for a close-up shot, the end.
Not enough. Still not enough.
Well, you can get stuck. That's as high as we go.
Hey.
This is just for starters. There'll be more later. You're talking about taking on Connors and a Warriors.
What are you, spineless?
Shut up.
You're happy, are you, with the way Connors operates?
Hasn't done nothing to me.
She hasn't done much for you either. Her little gang are the only ones who have any fun as far as I can see. The rest of us just sit and watch.
I have fun when I want. Got my own mates.
So have I. I'm getting more all the time. Connor's made herself pretty unpopular with a lot of people when she stopped the coke.
I suppose you're going to find us some.
Shouldn't be too difficult. Janet has friends on the outside. You side with us now, you'll get some. Free.
Yeah? How much?
Enough.
Nah, you haven't got a hope. Connor's is going to rip your heads off. But tell you what I will do. I'll keep the 20. And I won't tell them anything about what you just said.
No, I'll tell you what you'll do. You'll keep 5, because I happen to be feeling generous and because I know you're going to change your mind before too long. Connors isn't going to be around for too much longer. You side with her now, you'll be regretting it a lot sooner than you think.
Yeah, sure.
She's going to tell him.
No, she won't. She's got nothing to gain by it. The coke's got her interested. She'll just sit on the fence and see what happens.
And what coke's that?
I can't get that stuff in.
Look, you're the one who's always on about how many friends you've got. Get one in here for a visit. Set up a drop.
Just like that?
You're the one who wanted this partnership. Time you put something into it.
You wanted to see me?
Oh, yes. A small matter I wanted to discuss in private.
And what matter is that?
Well, you're aware of this engagement between my son and this Julie Egbert girl. Well, the whole thing's preposterous. And from what the girl says, you'd agree with me.
Whether I do or not, it's hardly any of my business.
Still, I suspect it wouldn't upset you greatly if the whole thing fell through. Do you have an office or somewhere we could speak privately?
No, I don't. And as a matter of fact, I'm off duty in a few minutes,
Oh, good. Then we can meet somewhere.
Mrs. Ryan, I couldn't care less if your son wants to ruin his life. As the matter stands, they have another 6 months to wait, so I suggest you just hope he comes to his senses.
Oh, I intend to do more than hope, Miss Ferguson. Perhaps you could ring me later, at your convenience. I have a proposal to make that I think you'll find very interesting.
I'm not sure I'll have any spare time later.
I'll be home all afternoon. Hope to hear from you.
Armed robbery? Roach and Ida. You expect me to believe that?
They've also been charged with aiding and abetting a fugitive. They're on their way here now.
Yeah, well, you better not take it out on Roach.
Why would I do that?
For helping Bongo after he went for Dan.
As a matter of fact, I was rather worried it might be you who'd give her a rough time.
Me?
He's been blaming her for getting caught.
Yeah, well, I'll wait and see what Roach says. I reckon it's probably the other way around.
Well, for once we seem to agree on something. Perhaps you'd like to keep an eye on her, see she stays out of trouble.
Yeah, we'll see what happens.
Yes. Well, that's all. You can go now. Miss Ferguson should be waiting outside. Would you ask her to come in?
Right. Thank you. Hope this won't take too long. I'm about to go off duty.
It won't. I've had some time to think since the minister's visit. I just want to make sure we understand each other.
Oh, if you think it needs clarifying.
Don't underestimate me, Miss Ferguson. I know exactly what you're up to. I know you manipulated the situation so the minister had to be brought in, and it's obvious you managed to get to him before he arrived.
Why don't you ask him?
However much you think you could run this prison, and however much you may have convinced him, the fact is you'd never succeed. You haven't got it in you. You'd make life a misery for staff and prisoners alike, and for that reason I am going to fight you all the way.
Well, that's up to you. Of course, the people who count are still on my side, and you've only got yourself to blame for that. If you weren't so weak, you'd still
have
been strong.
You'd better go now, Miss Ferguson, before you say something you'll regret.
If you think I'm being obstructive just for the sake of it, you're mistaken. You'd have my full cooperation if you ran this place properly.
You'd stop making trouble if I did things the way you want.
I didn't say that.
No, you never say anything, do you?
Oh, now, come on, Governor. Don't
as long as I have the breath to fight, you will never be running this prison. That's all. Now get out.
Your name is Rachel Waters and you're charged with armed robbery, aiding and abetting a fugitive and using insulting language to a police officer. Is that correct?
He used insulting language to me first.
That's enough. Just answer yes or no.
Well, I'm innocent because I was the hostage.
Hostages don't normally assault police officers, use abusive language and get themselves charged with contempt of court. Well?
Yeah.
Right. Come over here and empty your pockets.
And have you, Nico, anything you fancy? Not on your Nelly.
We have to list all your personal effects.
We aren't going to be here that long, are we?
It remains to be seen. Come on, let's get on with it, shall we?
Well, I just keep telling you, dear, I'm just an innocent bystander.
Another one of those. Must be a shortage of criminals. All the innocent bystanders we get in here.
Come on, come on. We haven't got all day.
See that one over there? Which I've one? Seen her somewhere before.
Big one.
Don't you worry about Miss Ferguson. Just get on with it, shall we?
Ferguson.
Right, your turn, Brown.
Oh, Stephen, look at you. Honestly, I can't turn my back for 5 minutes.
Oh, come on. You've been saying for ages you wanted this fixed.
By a tradesman. That is, after all, what they're for.
I enjoy fixing things. It's relaxing. Besides, I'm good at it. You can ask anyone at Wentworth.
Yes, well, actually, I've just come from there.
Wentworth?
Don't worry, I went through all the proper channels. I didn't climb over the fence.
Have you been talking to Julie?
Well, what other reason would I be going there?
Mother, if you've upset her...
Of course I didn't. I just wanted to meet my future daughter-in-law. Is that so strange?
What did you say to her?
Oh, I don't know. I can't remember. We just chatted. She really is a sweet little thing, isn't she?
Yes, she is. Sweet and loving and trusting. And I don't want you anywhere near her.
Well, now that I've met her, I've changed my mind. I think she's... well, she's not perfect for you. But if you're both in love, I suppose all I can do is give you my blessing.
Mother, I know you too damn well. Now, look, I'm not sure what you're up to. But if you really want to get to know her, you can come visit her with me. Otherwise, stay right away from her.
Well, of course, dear, if you feel so strongly about it.
Hey, Hello, dear. My word, you'll have to do something about your hot water system. Them showers, they're so cold. It's no good for me arthritis, you know.
You should have thought of that before you committed the robbery.
Robbery? Oh, there they go again. Accusing me of robbing someone. I'm innocent.
Anne, is there any way that I can...
The governor's name is Mrs. Reynolds.
This isn't Etty's boarding house, Waters. You're in serious trouble. I rather think you know that.
I was just trying to help Bong. Is there any way that I can talk to him?
No. Though there's nothing to stop you writing, except, I hope, common sense. You'd be much better off having nothing more to do with him.
I can't just ditch him. It's my fault he got caught.
Rubbish. The whole thing was his affair from start to finish. If he cared about you at all, he wouldn't have involved you.
Has, Ruth said anything?
I don't think she blames you, if that's what you mean. I've asked her to keep an eye on you and help you stay out of trouble.
You're not going to put us in with all them rough types, are you? A good citizen like me, I could be exposed to moral danger.
Neither of you will be in any danger, moral or otherwise, as long as you keep your noses clean. And that includes not getting involved in any schemes the women dream up. And being sensible about who you mix with. You're in enough trouble as it is. Don't make it any worse. Mrs. Morris?
Hello. Sorry I'm late. I was held up at work. Taxi driver seemed to find every red light in creation on the way here.
Well, there's no problem. The others have only just gone out. Time for a little glass of sun before you go, if you like.
No, thanks. I'll just catch my breath, though.
You seem in high spirits today.
Oh, yes. Well, there are going to be some changes made at work, and long overdue ones.
And obviously in your favour, eh?
Remains to be seen.
Now, don't worry. I don't want to know details. I know you don't like talking about it.
It's all right. The thing is, you see, the governor is, well, a well-intentioned person, but she's a hopeless idealist. She practically lets the prisoners run the place.
Yes, and there's always someone who'll take advantage of a situation, isn't there?
So you wouldn't disagree it was time someone did something about it?
If you were in a position to do so, all the better. The last thing we need is a prison system that kowtows to prisoners.
I'm glad you said that. I've always felt that a prison was a place where criminals should be punished, not pampered like spoilt children. They just might think twice before they commit their crimes, mightn't they?
Yeah, well, I couldn't agree with you more. And frankly, I think if more people in the prison service felt as you do, the rest of us might have a little more confidence in it, you know?
I hope Maxwell's as good a bet as you reckon. She puts one foot wrong and Connors will have your guts on a stick.
She won't. She's a real smarty. Got brains. Look how she fooled you all into believing she was a wimp.
Yeah, well, I still don't like her. But I don't like Connor's mob either, the way they're lording it over the rest of us.
Right. Count you in, then?
Yeah. But you better come good with the coke. That's what I'm interested in.
Stick with us and you'll have enough to take you from here to Mars.
So how are you getting it in?
That's my business. You just worry about your end of the deal.
Yeah, OK, but you better deliver, or it won't just be Connor's who'll have your guts.
Right, read this. If you've got any questions, ask Maxwell about them. She's been here long enough by now. OK, Brown, let's get you settled in.
Well, as long as it's nice, dear, and I've got a nice light for me cozy, you know, because I won't be here for long because on account of I'm innocent. But now, what about a telly?
I haven't really been here that long at all, but you learn fast in a place like this.
Yeah, I'm a bit out of it still. It all happened so quick. I've got someone in here I know. You know Rick Connors?
You're a friend of hers?
Well, yeah. Family, just about. Me and her brother, we sort of went out.
Then you better know you're not on friendly ground. Just stay right out of my way.
Why? What do you got against Reed? She's a top shiller.
You want to stay in one piece, you don't even breathe her name around me. Understand?
Yeah, look, sure.
For you.
I've... That bitch out there just flushed a knife at me. Something about she doesn't like Reed.
Brown, I thought I told you to stay put.
Oh, sorry, dear.
Is it all right if we have a look around?
Oh, I suppose so. Look, just get her to read this, will you? I can't seem to get through to her at all.
No worries.
Nasty type, that.
Her? Come off it, I'd. What about that one out at the front desk?
What's the matter, love?
I just remembered. That officer at the front, Ferguson.
What?
I thought the name rang a bell and I remembered where I've seen her before.
Where?
Jeez, I tell you, when Rita finds out about this, she's gonna kill the bitch.
My God.
Well, at least knowing his family's not against us, it'll make it easier having to wait so long.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, she was really nice.
Was she?
Yeah.
Yes. Yes.
Rita!
Oh, 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 in a hurry. Oh. I finally got you this time, eh?
Oh, I was a put-up job. I'm innocent.
Rachel! I reckon that idiot brother of mine finally dropped you in today. Hey, everyone, this is Rachel tonight. That's Lexie. Oh, look, you're getting
married.
Oh, yeah. So come on, tell us about it.
Oh, there's nothing much to tell. Cop spotted Ide's car and they were waiting when Bong tried to leave. Listen, man, I've got to talk to you about something.
Hey, there was blue shirts running all around the place, up and down the streets, and there was yelling and screaming and shooting and yelling.
Wow, hey, did no one get killed?
Killed, of course they did.
Oh, well, come off it, Ide. It was nothing like that.
What do you mean I was there? Wasn't I? And I seen it. Of course, I wasn't involved. Because I was just an innocent bystander.
What's going on? What are you two doing in here?
Oh, we were just having a look around.
Yes, look, it says quite clearly in the rule book.
All right, I'll take you back to the rec areas. The rest of you back to work.
Mrs. Morris, can I go to the loo?
Urgent, is it?
Yeah. Right, I'll escort you.
Oh, don't worry, I wouldn't want to put you to any trouble.
Come on.
Half a dozen golf balls.
I tell you what, it's a good thing that Robin and Carol had to leave as soon as we finished. Yeah. Now I've only got a shout for the two of us.
Yeah, well, you gave them a good run for your money, Joe.
Oh, I'm still a long way behind you.
Yeah, but you're closing fast. My order. Couple you have, eh?
Scotch and soda. Thank you.
Right, back in the gym.
Mrs. Ryan, Joan Ferguson. It seems as though I will have some free time this afternoon. Where would you like to meet?
What's this?
Just something to defend yourself with if you need to.
What if Reed catches me with it?
Tell her it's for self-defense. She won't do anything.
Like hell.
Well, she hasn't tried to take our knives, has she? Anyway, she's not going to know about it. Not unless you show it to her.
Suppose. How many of us are there anyway?
Enough. Look, I've got money and coke coming in. Enough to buy as much muscle as we need.
Fair enough.
I'm not stupid. I wouldn't be starting this if I wasn't sure we could win.
Well, all right. I've got to get back cleaning before the screws miss me.
Time you started getting your act together.
Yeah?
You need the coke.
Yeah, but I've got friends outside can put it together. But how are we supposed to get it in?
I'll have a think about it. While I'm fixing my new cellmate.
What's wrong with her?
Friend of Rita's. It's the last thing we need, her spying on me all the time.
How are you going to get rid of her?
I'm not going to try. It's easier just to make trouble between them, force them apart. Possibly even get her on our side.
Jeez, nothing devious about you, is there?
I'll be as devious as I have to if it means surviving in this place.
Wait!
Yeah?
Hey, look, what is it you wanted to tell me? You better make it quick. I'm not supposed to be here.
Well, when they were bringing us in here, out of the front desk, there was this screw that walked past. Big Sheila, nasty looking. Hmm. She had to go with Ide about something.
Yeah, that'd be Ferguson, the freak. You'll be seeing a lot more of her, I can tell you.
Well, that's the thing. I have seen her before, but I couldn't think where. Then I remembered. It was outside your place.
My place?
Yeah. Well, she had this funny scarf thing over here, but I recognised her. Face like that, you can't hardly forget.
Well, when the hell was this?
The night the shed went up and all the bikes got burnt.
You're trying to tell me the freak was there that night?
I didn't think nothing of it at first.
But what would she be? The thought never even occurred to me.
That fire was just after the boys did over her place.
That's where I heard her name. Some of them were talking about
it. The Eagles had nothing to do with that fire. It was Ferguson. You know what else it means? That fire started the fight where Slasher was murdered. That bitch murdered him. I don't want either of you two saying anything about this to anyone, you understand?
I won't. What you gonna do, Rita?
I've got a phone call to make.
Oh, God.
Oh, I really must go, Andrew. Thanks again for the game.
Thank you. Joan, I was thinking if you're not doing anything this evening, would you like to have dinner with me?
No, I'm sorry, I can't.
Oh, that's a pity. It's just that I haven't been to a restaurant for a while and I find you most enjoyable company.
Well, thank you. Actually, I have another engagement, but I do enjoy our golf.
That's good.
Well, I really must go.
Yeah. Well, to the next round then, eh? Well, I'll probably be popping into the pub later on if you're passing by. Pop in and say hello.
Oh, I don't think I'll have the time. But thanks anyway. Bye.
Bye.
Oh, that was enjoyable. George, it's Rick Connors.
G'day, Rick. Thought you were inside.
You better believe it. Look, I just wanted you to know that Roach got here, okay?
Ah, good one. How's she doing?
I'm looking after her, don't worry. She puts her foot out of line, I kick her butt.
Good on you, Rick. Listen, sorry to hear about Bong.
Yeah, well, turn inside might teach him a few things. Nothing else seems to. You could take a leaf or two out of your book, eh, George?
Hey, I know you calling George anyway. No one's called me that since I got my first set of oils.
Who's Connor's talking to?
Walter's older brother. She wants to reassure him she's keeping an eye on the girl.
Good. Hasn't changed to see her doing something that isn't making trouble for someone. Have a look at these, will you, Meg? Some of these figures look decidedly strange to me. I'm wondering if the department's computer hasn't gone haywire again.
Sure.
Yeah, that's right. Look, I haven't got time to go over it again. You just make sure you do a good job. For me and the gang. I'll see you. Lynette, Mrs. Morris.
Right, is everything all right?
Yep, no worries.
Miss Ferguson. Good to see you again.
Look, I don't have a great deal of time. Could you get to the point?
You strike me as an extremely capable officer. Professional, diligent.
If that's all you wanted to tell me.
I'm hoping you might prove capable of helping me. I'm prepared to pay handsomely for it.
And what makes you think I'm open to bribery?
What I want you to do is entirely in the public interest. This, Egbert girl, she's going to be released soon. She'll be free to take advantage of people. Decent people. People she has no business associating with.
I see. People like yourself and your son, eh?
Exactly.
And what do you expect me to do about it?
I would like you to arrange for a sentence to be increased by whatever means is necessary.
Is that all? Oh, you're living in a fairyland, Mrs. Ryan. The system doesn't work that way.
I believe it could, with your help.
And why would I want to help you?
Because I'm offering you $10,000, that's why.
Hey, old Ida seems like a ton of fun. I bet she and Eddie have been great, mate.
Oh. Yeah, it'd be hard telling which one had more screws loose, eh?
Is there any work being done in here, or is it all just talk?
Oh, no, work, Mrs. Morris. Honest. Mm.
Hey. You were gone a long time. What happened?
Found something out, that's what. It was the freak organised the gang maneuver and got Slasher killed. Murdering bitch!
What are you going to do?
First, I talked the screws into letting me speak to Roach's brother.
So?
He's in the gang. They're going to organise a nice little surprise for that...
Gonna bash her? Nah, wheel stands on her face, eh?
What, Reed? She's so keen on fires. Let's see how she likes her own bloody house burned down.
Oh, beauty. Hope you told him to do it while the bitch was inside.
I told him to do it when she isn't, eh?
Anyone deserves being roasted, it's her.
Especially after what she did to Slasher.
Fires for the game. What she did to Slasher's a personal matter. I'm going to settle that myself.
He used to give me roses. I wish he could again. But that was on the outside, and things were different then. On the inside, the sun still shines, and the rain falls down. But the sun and rain are prisoners too. Last night I dreamed we were together.
The rose is here.